How to create boss, we can just show, go for the new part. Okay, so we can create new part. Okay, we can name that as a screw boss or heat shrinking boss. The part point now. So this plane and point we can hide. Okay, so we'll check how we can add a new geometric set. We need to add as for the input. So input we can add other, as well as we need another geometric set as a work. So we can create work as a geometric set. Okay, we can add over here access system. We'll add first point. It will be at 0, 0 or something like, we can make it as a 10. 10 or 10, I think you can take. And now we can insert over here axis system. So we can insert over here axis with respect to XYZ will be similar, only we can change the origin here. You can find, once we apply that, it will be moved with respect to this. Okay, so either you can keep over here as well as you can move the axis system with respect to input. You can move over here. Okay, so this is the axis system we're going to be have for this particular part. Okay, so you can add another axis system and make this as a active. Okay, so it means not like this part will be have the active system like this. You can double click and you can select this as a 0, 0 condition. Add this. Yeah, so this is nothing but the access system we're going to be have, and with respect we're going to be now create sketch. Okay, so sketch we can create with the position sketch. With respect to the reference plane, we're going to be select on this axis system XY. Okay, then select point, projection point will be what we have created, so that we can name as a start point. So this is how we need to create a boss. So we need to have a circle of 8 mm we can create right now. We can create 8 mm circle now, something like this. We'll add another part body. Okay, so this will be the body we can create. Okay, so we can create a body, like we can name as a boss as well. No issues. We can name as a boss, and with respect to this pad, we can something like do over here with respect to. So we can add over here 10 mm. Okay, something like this. We can do the 10 mm. And with respect to that, we can go for the mirror both side over here. Okay, something like this we can do. Or with respect to that. Okay, so whatever we have created the pad over here, with respect to that, you can check, like double click this pad and go for over here as a thick. Okay, so we can create the thick, and with respect to that, the only inside we can create the thickness, not the outside. So you can check the preview, something like this. We're going to be on the thickness command. With respect to that, you can create the boss. Now, whatever we have created that, we need to add the draft. So we can create the draft with respect to over here. We can select the surfaces, and now we're going to be select the plane with the neutral plane. We're going to be select where we are drawn the sketch. Okay, so this is something I can create, and the draft we can give as a 0.5, that this is a B side feature we're going to be have. I wrote it should be upside somewhere here. Okay, so this is going to be create, as well as we need to have the tooling line. So tooling line we need to create with respect to this point and plane. So you can find this point. And nothing but the Z direction we can create separately. Point and direction will be Z. Okay, something like we can create Z direction over here. And now we can name to this as a start point. We can name this as a tooling line. Now the most important thing, we need to have, we have the access to access, we need to keep this as a Z. Okay, so what happened with this, like what, whenever we change the tooling direction, okay, so this axis system will be get changed, and with respect to that we'll get a change in the shape. Okay, so we need to create like here and there, like another way we're going to be create. So in that case we're going to be have this condition. Okay, so somewhere here we can create now. So this is something like the boss we can create, but now if you just check, like we can consider this as a heat stacking boss. Okay, or it might be something like screw bus. Okay, so screw bus will have the from top, we have the rib. Okay, so we can create the rib over here with the sketch plane on XY. Okay, here the point, we can select the position point with respect to this center zero. Click on OK. Something like this we can create. And now we can have the line from this to this. Okay, as well as from here to here, we're going to have a line. And that we can give the dimension. It's something like over here is 20. We're going to get the 20. Why are we going to select the 20? Is something like whatever the resting we required over here on this portion is something like 5 plus. Okay, same over here, 5 plus. We already consider like 8. So 8 plus this 10, it's something like 18. We're going to be here, and extra if we add the fillet and all that, it will be consumed. So for that reason, we are given 25 somewhere here. So now we can check, like, we need to go for symmetry. So we can select this as symmetry. Okay, we can just out over here. So whenever there is a screw boss or hinge stacking boss, you can find when we have the hinge stacking boss, we need to have something like this geometry itself. Okay, so you can give the thickness 1 mm both sides. So something like this we can create, but now we are just checking for we can create this boss as a screw boss. Okay, so we can have the both sides over here. And we can just now have union trim. So for that we need to add this to inside some another assembly and this into the another assembly. Okay, so for that we need to do union trim. We need to select what to keep or what to remove. Okay, so this top inside one we want to remove, so this is how we can remove. Okay, so with respect to that we need to add draft for this particular ribs. Okay, so we can add 0.5 drop to the all the surfaces faces with like this. Okay, with respect to selecting the faces somewhere here, 0.5 top tooling direction way to select. Click okay. So this is how we're going to be create. And then we need to select the drop to this particular chamfer. Okay, so we can select this as a chamfer body. We can add the draft little bit more. Select the bottom because we want to have from the bottom, we need to control. Somewhere like here, we're going to be have 15 or 20 will be okay. 15 will be okay, 15 to 17 will be okay for us. Okay, something like this, you can create the boss. Okay, it's asking for the trim faces. Okay, select double click. So you can select this surface. Okay, something like this, you can create. And I can add the fillet over here. So you'll check for fillet. Okay, something like this we can add fillet. So here you can adjust this draft. Okay, so with respect to that you can get the like upper side some flat portion to rest. Okay, something like this you can adjust, you'll get the flat portion to adjust over here. Okay, so this is how we're going to be create the boss, and now we need to do the draft analysis for this. So you can check the draft analysis for this is nothing but insert analysis, go for draft analysis, then select the material condition at the bottom somewhere here. Okay, so you can select this material condition, click OK. And then you need to keep this compass on this red dot, you need to position twice always. Okay, then select this particular boss and you can find we have the 0.5 degree draft. Okay, so we already added a 0.5 degree draft over here. So with respect to that, we can create. So these are going to be create the boss, and this is nothing but the important B side feature we're going to be on. Now we need to do the power copy. So add the another point, you need to add a new geometrical set. Okay, so boss 2 we're going to be here, and over here we're going to be add a new point. Okay, so point will be something like we're going to be add 150. Let's check preview. Somewhere here we're going to be here. And tooling direction, we can just keep the same. And now we need to create first power copy of this particular. So go for the insert, new template, go for the power copy creation, select the only start point, tooling line, and yeah, these are the two input we can select. And with the click of OK, you can get generate the power copy here. Now we need to recall the power copy. From instantaneous of the selection, we can recall the power copy with this start point and tooling line. Check for the preview. You can create the power copy identical over here. Okay. So in this, now we can create this as a heat stacking bus. Okay. So we can create that. So whatever we're going to be have, that pad, we just remove that pad. Okay. Something like this, we're going to be create this as a heat stacking bus. So whatever we have, the BIW, so that BIW, we're going to be the another part we have, that another part will be something like over here, and can get that heat stacking. Okay, so we can check something like this, we're going to be at the intersect. Okay, something like this, we're going to be at the part, and to this part, we're going to be get the another part welded. Okay, so here you can check. So this is nothing but the part we're going to be have. So this is, we have boss. Okay, something like this we're going to be have. Okay, to this boss, now we can find like what are we going to be have? Another part, so that another part will be get joined, okay? So can find something like this, will be the another part resting on this particular flat portion. Okay, so this is how we're going to be at the another part. We're going to be rest on this particular flat portion. Right here you can check something like this. We're going to be here. So now once we have the welding done, okay, so what will be happen once we have the welding done? So whatever the portion we're going to be have, so it will be land on this particular surface. Okay. It will land something like this. Okay. So it will be became something like this once we have gone for the heat stacking. Okay. So this is something like we have the heat stacking boss. Okay. So and sorry, it will be something I'm having a melt over here. And it will get locked. So this is nothing but the permanent joint we're going to have. This is the part A. This is part B. So this is going to be get assembled over here. Okay. So here you can find like whatever we're going to be have the heat stacking boss or either the screw boss. It a little bit changes with respect to the dimension. You can edit anytime. You can do the power copy. You can save this as a power copy. You can recall from the document as well. Okay. So these are the two types of the power copy we're going to be create. Okay. So this is for today. See you then.